Yo Estokwa, Dean Hunt Klanugwa, Hektuk Nugwa. Hi, my name is Dean Hunt. I'm from the Heltsuk Nation, Bella Bella, BC. Growing up, we always had pencils and paper at our disposal. We just created on the paper, going to that fantasy land, try and create what you see in your mind. Just out of high school, I got my first DJ stuff. Just found that those two things really bounced off the other, so to speak. And in high school, got really into hip-hop, influenced by like early album covers. A lot of comic books as well, the really graphic, hard-edge stuff. I've incorporated some of the ideas of hip-hop into certain pieces, just trying to make something fresh. I'd made some oversized pendants that represent the Flavor Flav clock, you know, or the Slick Rick, you know, really big jewelry, right? But always trying to use fresh colors.
Dean's style is between traditional and non-traditional. Most Native artists come from the ancestry. He has the traditional, but he also has the new age.
I did a lot of skateboarding growing up, doing some construction work as well. I was at the skateboard bowl in Gibson's. I wiped out, separated my shoulder, and broke my elbow. That kind of was the end of my skateboard career. Started hanging around the studio with my pops, started drawing more, and so that was kind of a blessing in disguise because it kind of directed me back home. The Wild Man of the Woods character, Pukwas, I'm always drawn to him. He's basically trying to lure you into the in-between, the ghost world. I keep revisiting that theme. We can be led astray. I think a little bit of him lives within me as well. When I first got into Heltsuk artwork, I was doing a lot of jewelry. And then I got into doing the carving. We got a big project for a local fella here, doing a big entranceway for him. It was such a great experience. 2 years solid carving together as a family, and we just had that one common goal. I was also DJing and scratch DJing, and it was a good thing for my mind, just kind of let my mind breathe for in a different way. The cedar speaks to you, maybe whispers at first. Sometimes I'll have a design and I'm looking for a piece of wood to execute that design on. The way that I would make beats, it was more of a collage style, quite a bit different than the carving, because carving is all subtractive. You start with the block and you whittle it down, whereas the beats were always additive. You start with a kick and a snare and a hi-hat, building it up that way. Definitely rhythm is one thing that ties the beats and the carving together. Can't help but carve to the beat of the music, the Hawaiian slack key or the hip hop. And I'll put on the heavy metal for the heavy work as well, right?
His beats are incredible. You just want to dance and have a good time, and just makes you feel happy.
To receive this Fulmer Award is a great honor. I'm very humbled, and everyone who's won is just such a great artist. To be alongside of some of my heroes is huge, yeah.